and you have been in more than 50 films in the last 30 years. Do you have a single favorite role?
Aside from being there, I think the film I most enjoyed being in was Dr. Strangelove, two particular characters. Aside from that, being there was an ambition, you know, that I wanted to do all my life.
What did you like about Strangelove?
I liked the character of the doctor, and I liked the character of the group captain, Mandrake, yes. Those two, and lovely memories of Stanley Kubrick and Terry Southern. And
do you ever go back and see your movies? Do you like to watch yourself in the movies? Do you watch them on television, or do you go to the theaters and watch your movies?
No. I went last night to see Being There because I hadn't seen it with an audience. And it was very interesting to see the reaction, you know, on various levels. Of course, the audiences here are very sophisticated. They pick up very quickly, I notice, on little innuendos.
Really?
Yes.
In different parts of the world, you think audiences act differently to the same film?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I haven't seen that in other parts of the world. But other films, they do, yes.
What's the difference between a California audience and a London audience, for instance?
Well, a London audience and a New York audience are identical.
I mean,
if you're taking a West End audience, right,
yeah,
identical. They're very hip. And I would say, like, in Westwood, about the same.
About the same.
But you get out of those areas in England, and you're in a totally you got to be careful what you show them.
Who are you talking as now? Somebody told me you have no voice. Time magazine's cover story insisted that there is no Peter Sellers, that you are only a mass of characterizations, and that inside there is no body.
That's true, yes.
How did you react to that?
Well, I didn't react. I just mouthed things. This is not entirely true. It comes from working for years in radio, Gene.
Who am I talking to now?
Let me see. He's not in, I'm sorry. Anybody there? No.
How does somebody who comes from London talk?
Well, I mean, there are so many London accents. It's difficult to say. You know, people think of Cockney accent. There are five Cockney accents.
All right.
And there are other accents that are also from London. And then you have cultured London.
Well, let's hear them.
Well, you want to hear...
Sure, I want to hear some accents. I want to hear you speak various Englishes.
The people over here have difficult enough time understanding Michael Caine, so I don't know.
I'll put subtitles on as you speak.
Well, I'll tell you straight out, Gene. What I like about you and your show is you're frank. No, I don't mean like the name. I mean what you say is frank. Now, I likes that because it gets to the core, see? And when you get to the core, you get the essence. Precious bodily essence.
No, that's an old sort of Cockney accent.
And what happens when you get into...
Oh, do you mean one of theirs? One of the Hooray Harris? Yes. The Hooray Harris, yes. Well, they're very good on TV. And they're quite erudite, you know, and there's a... It's very interesting, Mr. Shallot, that you should come on the show. How long have you been doing your show in New York, is it?
It's been 64 years.
64 years. How absolutely amazing.
And you haven't asked me a new question yet.
No. Well, of course, I've only just started myself.
I see.
It's just that I went to Oxford, that's it.
And what happens when you have to sell something? What do you say when you have to sell a product on television? How do you cue the control?
Well, all those TV selling voices are more or less the same, you know. They're the same all over the world. Get so-and-so today, you know? Even in Russia, I did one once about cigarettes. Comrades, smoke bruchkins. Bruchkins are not merely the coolest, the finest, and the best cigarettes in Russia. They are the only cigarettes in Russia. You know, that's a rough...